Hey, how's it going, everyone? In this video, we're gonna cover syllable stress rules for words with two syllables. So what that means is that we need to identify which syllable is stressed and unstressed, and we also need to apply the characteristics that make it obvious for the listener that the syllable is either stressed or unstressed. So starting off with nouns, adjectives, and adverbs. If a noun, adjective, or adverb is two syllables, the stress is usually on the first syllable. So that means the rhythm pattern will be like this. Dada, dada, dada. Notice how in the unstressed syllable, the energy is falling off at the end. Dada. So some examples, table, jacket, yellow, happy, often, always. Of course, there are exceptions. So if the word is an exception, the rhythm pattern will be da-da, da-da, da-da. So some examples of exceptions are event, advice, police, hotel. Verbs and prepositions that are two syllables usually have a stress on the second syllable. So that means the rhythm pattern will be da-da, da-da, da-da. So some examples are become, afford, decide, above, below, and outside. Again, we do have exceptions, so if the word is an exception to the rule, the stress pattern will be like this. Dada, dada, dada. So some examples of exceptions are over, after, argue, and follow. If a word can be both a noun and a verb, then the word generally follows these rules. So for example, the word contest as a noun has a first syllable stress, and as a verb has a second syllable stress. Contest, contest, contest. Same with address. As a noun, first syllable stress, address. As a verb, address. Hey, what's your address? He decided to address the crowd. So that's how it works. And now that you know about this, you can start tuning your ears to it and using it in your everyday conversation. And that means you just boosted up your English.